Hi, welcome to product review by Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri. In this video, we are going to do the review of this TP5100 lithium battery charger for one or two cell. I'm going to explain the module. I'm going to show you how to wire it to one cell battery. And also then I'm going to show you how to connect it to two cell battery. And then I'm going to charge one battery and measure the current and voltage for the output and also voltage for the input. And then we are going to charge two batteries and show you also the current. And then I'm going to use the thermal camera to show you which spot is getting hot the most. Also, I'm going to short circuit the output and show you what happens if you short circuit it. And also I'm going to show you if you connect the polarity incorrectly, the positive and negative, if you connect it incorrectly. Let's get started with this. This is the module. You might see it with different colors, but the whole shape would be the same. This is the main chip, TP5100. Chip is from Top Power ACIS from China. And we have an inductor. There is a Schottky diode here. And this has been labeled here clearly for the input. They have labeled it as 5 to 15. The chip can handle up to 18 volts, but because of the capacitors here, maybe they have limited. These two are for the output. These two terminals here, you will solder them or making short circuit between these two, so you can connect two cell batteries. Keep in mind that this is not a cell balancer. It will just charge the battery and it doesn't know which cell. For example, if you connect two cells, you would not know which cell has lower voltage or charged less and which one has the most. For that, you have to get a different module that can do that. This is just a very simple. You can have different currents. This is sold with preset value of 2 ampere. Here we have resistors. These two resistors are in parallel. And by changing these resistors, you can reduce the current. If you go on AliExpress and search TP5100, these are the search results that you get. You can even purchase the chip alone, but these are the modules that you can see. You will see it as a black, green, or red. And the prices are, depending on where you buy it from, would be 10 pieces for $10 or less or more. For example, if I click on this one, you can see they are selling it for 81 cents Canadian. This is around 60 cents or 70 cents US, and they ask for $6.76 for the shipping, so you can get it in between 50 to 30 business days. Here the same store is selling it for $7.19 with 76 cents shipping, but you will get it between 40 to 60 business days. This will take like 90 days, but you will receive it, or you can select a higher shipping to get it faster. Now let's have a look at the datasheet using Google Translated page. The rated current, the maximum current it can handle is 2 ampere, which I'm going to test it and show you. And if you set it for two cells, the voltage would be 8.4 volts, the output voltage. And if you set it for one cell, it will be 4.2 volts for lithium battery. Input voltage has this is rated for the chip, 5 to 18. But on the module, it is up to 15 volts. The switching frequency is 400 kilohertz. This is the frequency that the internal converter will convert from 5 to 18 volts to your voltage, and it will be turned on and off at this frequency to reduce it. As you can see, it says it has power MOSFET for anti-flow back, which means the current will not go back from your battery to the charger. We have two LEDs, red for charging. In our case, it will be blue. That's for standby. And we have chip temperature protection, which means if it heats up, it will turn off. Overcurrent protection, it will not allow more current to pass through. And under voltage protection, it will not allow the voltage, the input voltage, when the voltage goes low, the output will turn off and it will prevent it. It has a battery temperature protection. If you connect this from external circuitry, this does not apply to this module. Battery reverse connection shutdown. If you connect the output incorrectly, it will shut it down, and then you have short circuit protection. If you short circuit the output, it will protect it. We have a 20 microhenry inductor. This inductor is 20 microhenry, and I removed it from this chip. So this is an inductor inside that is just a wiring with a core. The maximum junction temperature is 120 degrees inside the chip. The operating temperature is minus 40 to 85 degrees Celsius. This is for the storage. So pin temperature can go up to 260 degrees when you solder it. The welding time or soldering time of 10 seconds. And now let's have a look at the schematic. When the configuration is 4.2 volts or one cell, the input can be expected to go up to 5 volts because we expect 4.2 volts, so it can go lower. And here we have one battery, one cell, and this pin, the pin 13, this is the charge select, is not connected to anywhere. When you power it up, this LED will turn on, this pin 14 will go low, so it will turn it on, and when the charge starts, then this pin will go low and the red will turn on. But if we use it for two cells, and the output voltage will be 2 battery and the voltage will be 8.4 volts. In this case, because the output is 8, we can have, let's say, 9 or 9.5 volts at the input, but here the example shows 12 volts. And everything else is the same with, except this charge select pin is connected to this pin, and that causes the output to jump to 8.4 volts, and you can connect two cells here. And if you apply solder here and short circuit it, it will work for two cells. Here the three pins that are available on the board, they're nothing but the pins for the LEDs. This pin on this side, it is connected directly to the charge pin. The last one is connected to the standby pin, pin 14, or this side of LED. And this, the middle pin is connected to the resistor here, which I've shown it here, just the anode of both of these. So this is for the purpose that in case if you want to turn on and off LED or something else when charge is completed, so you can connect your own wires at these points. And here I've soldered these two wires at these two points. So when I connect them, the output voltage will be adjusted for two cells. And here for the wiring, on this side we will connect the negative, and the positive will be connected in here. And here is how I've done it. I've connected these two wires for the input. This is for my input, and these two wires are for the output. Either if you connect it with two cells or one cell, this is the output. But for the two cells, you can solder it here permanently if you're using two cells. But in my case, for the test purpose, I put this so I can twist this and create short circuit here. And now this will work for two cells. And if I remove it, it will work for one cell. And here, let me connect the power. Currently, there is no power. When I turn it on, the blue LED will turn on. The output is not connected to anything. These are just left without connection. And now I'm going to connect the positive to the positive. This side is the positive. And the negative on this side, when I connect it, as soon as the charge starts, it will become red. Let me show you my wiring. The input is connected via these two wires in here, and I've connected the voltmeter so you can see it is 12.1 volts at the moment. And the output, these two wires will be connected to the battery, or I will show you also the current that it goes through my meter. But I've also connected this to the output, this voltmeter, so you can see the charge voltage. At the moment it shows 4.1 volt. I have not connected these two wires, these two points, via this wire. Now if I connect it, you will see that it will jump to 8.4, because this is 4.2, this is 4.1 and something, because this doesn't show. So it becomes two cell. and I'm going to connect two batteries later. For now, we will go with a one cell battery. I have connected the meter, the current meter, so the positive goes directly to this battery. This side is positive, and the positive of that goes here. The output, the negative goes here and exits, and this is my negative from the meter. And as you can see, that's the voltage. Let me connect it. And that's the current that at the moment it is charging. Amount of current directly related to the voltage of this battery. As the battery gets charged, the voltage increases slowly, and well, the current will decrease, and finally it will shut off. As you can see, this current is now reducing slowly because this is filling up. Now let me show you this one cell battery. If we measure the voltage, as you can see, it shows 3.7. If I connect it now, you will see that's the maximum current that this charger can supply. And here is the thermal image, as you can see. So in terms of temperature, this inductor is getting hotter than the chip. And if the inductor gets hotter, that's okay, because there is nothing to burn, it's just a wire. Because now this is 3380 milliampere hour, so you can divide the capacity by this one. This is 1920, and you will know how long it will take. So this one now will take around 2 hours to complete this if this was empty. You can see voltage is slowly increasing. Perhaps it's 1.5 or something, that's why it's fluctuating. And here how you connect the one battery, the positive will be to the battery terminal, the negative will be to the negative. So this is 0 volts and 3.7, as they call it. But once it gets fully charged, it will be 4.2 volts, the maximum for the lithium. But here is how you connect the second battery. When you connect the second cell, the positive of this will go to the negative of the S2 or second cell, and the voltage will add up here with a 7.4 volts. So we are going to connect our two cells like this. And here is my battery. This positive goes to the charger. This is the negative. I'm connecting here a connector. Here is how I have connected it. So this is my negative for the charger, and that's the positive. So to connect that first, I have to circuit these two wires. So the output voltage is for two cell. So now it is ready for two cell because the voltage increased. The negative, I'm connecting it. Two cell is being charged, and as you can see, the voltage has dropped here. The reason is for that, one of the batteries, it has low voltage, and the current shows here, 1972 milliampere. Now the input current is 1.48. And as you can see, the hottest spot is the actual chip, not the inductor, this spot. So that's the hottest spot, the actual chip. But 84 degrees is not that critical for the chip. Now let's test the short circuit protection. Maybe it's dying, I'm just gonna do it, and let's see if it smokes or it turns off. Now, this is the maximum current that is passing through this, and it shut it down. Perfect, so the short circuit protection is working. Here now, let's connect the polarity incorrectly. So the positive, I'm going to connect it to the negative, and the negative, I'm going to connect it to positive and see what happens if it dies or not. You see, it just smoked. So, reverse polarity protection on the module did not work. Let's turn it off and then let's connect it back and see if it works. I'm connecting the positive now to the positive and negative in here. And as you can see, it is charging, and but I saw smoke. So reverse polarity protection might not work because I saw smoke there. Thank you for watching the tutorial by Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And make sure to subscribe, as I will have a lot of other videos related to this topic. And here for the wiring, on this side we will connect the